Hey everybody, it's Evicta. It's time to continue the Eden Streak here in the Mining of Isaac Evicta Afterbirth Plus series. The like streak is on hold because it's not been 24 hours since the last episode came out, but I do want to say thank you everybody. We are sitting at 368 in a row, looking for 369, feeling fine. Yeah, hopefully we have more movement speed than we did yesterday, and we already do. Seed Day is going to be Mass AK-27. Rob, we've got the tier detonator. Good damage, good tiers, acceptable movement speed, mystery sack. Not a bad start. Terrible shot speed, though. But shot speed is not really a concern when you have a 7-tier delay to start off the run with, and that is A-OK by me. What is the tier detonator? Tier detonator does this. Yep. I'd be lying if I said it's the most exciting item in the entire game. It's not really one that I ever utilize. I just look for a reason to replace it. Can be okay, I suppose, if you have like something like a combination of Pyro plus Ipecac, maybe, but for the most part, it's a pretty boring item. I'm just going to be honest. Also, starting with, well, we had 2 soul hearts, but now it's down to 1.5. And yeah, how about that first impressions of One Finger Death Punch 2? That came out of nowhere, man. That was a complete shock to me. One Finger Death Punch 1 was one of my favorite games ever, and TB actually was the person who introduced me to the entire game. One day we'll get a soul heart out of Tinted Rock. I don't know why that keeps happening, but yeah. I also have an Emperor's card. But yeah, One Finger Death Punch 2 is going to be awesome. It's hilarious they had Twitch integration. Thank you, game. I have a feeling the boss is going to be down to the southwest, so let's go down here and find the item room first. Overall, this is a pretty good... It's a good start. If we can get a little bit more damage and a little bit more tier shot speed, we're going to be golden, I think. Of course, RimWorld is still going to be running 5 days a week. Hollow Knight, we had an episode coming up today, actually, and that's going to be the last episode of the week. I may do one on Sunday. I don't know. I honestly don't know how much longer I have on Hollow Knight to go. Like, I don't want to overstay my welcome when it comes to a non-scheduled series. I wasn't really my intention of doing 3 series at once. I wanted one of the series to end because I really only have time to do 2 without going insane. But Hollow Knight, I know there's Tinted Rock there. I'll go back and get it if I remember. But Hollow Knight is good enough to where I do want to continue it. It's nothing against the game. But having 3 series run simultaneously on top of each other is a little bit much. And I think that it's... I run into a situation, and it's the reason why I don't normally do 3 series at once. I used to a long time ago, but not anymore. And that's because you have to... I'm pretty conscious. That's a great sentence. I'm very aware that everyone here on YouTube has a certain amount of time for their day. And having 3 videos per day is asking quite a lot of your audience, which I completely understand with. I'm on y'all's side. As someone who watches YouTube a lot as well, like, I hear you. Like, there's no way. I'm not going to watch a YouTube channel for the entire day. Like, that's not what I have planned, you know? So I'm very conscious to the fact that, you know, I want to be courteous, and I also don't want to spam people's inboxes. Now, that was back in the time where, like, YouTube actually had, surprise, surprise, delivery of subscriptions in your subscription box. I know. Ain't crazy, you know? It's what kind of a world are we living in now? Well, YouTube doesn't do that anymore. And what I've been telling people is essentially basically just, like, bookmark the channel page. I mean, that's the best way I can say, and the best recommendation that I've got to help people see the videos when they come out. A lot of people have been saying that the Isaac series actually has not been getting delivered, but the other series have been, which is strange, but also kind of ironic. I mean, I guess the algorithm kind of does its thing, and then we're just sort of wondering. And if there's ever been a statement that summarized YouTube better than that, it's that right there. Now, I know that we can get into the cursed room here using 2 bombs, but I'm not going to use the bomb, mainly because we actually have a little bit of HP to spare. Even if we didn't get HP here as well, I'd still want the bombs for the donation machine inside the store. But I do know that the secret room is right here, and I will prove that to you real quick. We're going to go take a look at the store and see what we got with this one bomb here. Trinket Smelter is infinitely better than the Tier Detonator. So thank you to the Tier Detonator for showing up. I appreciate your candor and courage and spirit. But we are looking at we're looking to go a different direction here in the company and the team. Look at that. We get the freaking Daemon's Tail. That's going to be a good one to start with. Daemon, I did it again. I used Trinket Smelter too dang soon. Okay, so this is kind of an amateur, not even a pro tip, amateur tip. And I'll demonstrate to you what just happened. So Daemon's Tail, you're like, oh, hey, converts pickups to hearts to pickups, decreases the spawn rate of hearts. Oh, hey, that sounds pretty good here. Let me go over here, and I'm just going to pick it up. And then you use Trinket Smelter. Oh, it didn't smelt. Why? Well, because you have to wait until Isaac drops his arms out of the air. Otherwise, it's not going to work. So now I have it. Now I can smelt it. What the Trinket Smelter does, by the way, is it will take a passive. It will take a trinket and turn it into a passive power. Now, I wouldn't recommend doing that with Daemon's Tail like I just did, because it does reduce the amount of hearts that drop. But Daemon's Tail also creates a lot more black hearts than normal. And it also just makes things drop more. So it's good and bad in a way. I think it's a good trinket overall, though. I think it was Monstro. We get yet another HP upgrade and a blank deal with the devil. All right. We'll use the Ensign's Rune here, which is going to give us full mapping as well as the blue map. Only reason why I'm going over here is because we need keys, and I do want to see what's inside of this mob trap room. I don't particularly want to do a mob trap room run, or at least not on this floor anyway, but we have to. Now, the petrified poop is an excellent trinket to smelt. It's one that's going to pay dividends for the entire run, essentially. And it's one of the most important trinkets that you can pick up in the early goings here. So having two pretty solid trinkets show up within one floor of each other after getting the trinket smelter is pretty fortunate. For the key drop over here, Midas Touch is too good not to take. Midas Touch will allow us to deal contact damage to enemies, anyone that touches us, based on the amount of money that we have. That would determine how much damage we do. And of course, more importantly, anything that we do touch, actually physically touch with Isaac's body, or anything that comes into contact with us, vice versa, will turn into gold. And then if we shatter their bodies while they're frozen in solid gold, they actually create money. So if you have a way of recharging either your red hearts or your soul hearts, it's an excellent way, especially if you combine it with Nun's Habit, it's an excellent way to make almost infinite money, as long as you have, like, you know, something to turn into gold. It does work on bosses too. One of the very few freeze crowd control abilities that do have an effect on bosses. And a fun little fact is that Midas Touch actually will make you not take damage the first time that the Mom Foot comes down. I'm speaking about Mom's Foot specifically here. But if you have Midas Touch, it will actually freeze as soon as it makes contact with Isaac's head, and not actually count as a damaging hit. So that's a little bit of a more advanced tip for y'all. All right, we have plenty of HP here. I would love to get in the cursed room. Got some bombs as well. And we get free entry in here thanks to that black soul heart. And look at that extra bomb and a golden key as well for the mystery sack. Golden key is going to give us unlimited keys here, including, but not limited to, entry doors, golden chest, locks, store, that sort of thing. This room's actually awful. Luckily, we didn't get the creepy crawly. We just got the one that just shoot another key. I'm very happy with that. Pay to play would at least allow us to get into rooms without having to worry about having a key anymore. I mean, deep pockets is not terrible. I guess we can take it. I kind of didn't want to, though, just because we have Midas Touch, and I don't want to lose that contact damage. The higher that our money stores get, the more damage we're able to deal, to dish out. Now, we don't really have a suicide run yet, or a kamikaze run yet, because we don't have any orbitals. But if we do get an orbital, or if we get the virus or Serpent's Kiss, something like that, then you bet your bottom dollar we're going to be using an offensive Midas Touch build, which is a lot of fun and very powerful as well. If we get there. See the arrow here pointing to this wall. people are still mystified when I'm talking about the arrow. That's okay. At this point, I'll let them figure it out for their own. It's just gonna sound like just random rambling. I try to be like, oh, hey, this is where the arrow is over here. I mean, I try to do that, but people still think I've lost my mind. I'm gonna be really lazy here. Skip one room. Don't do that, but there's no reason for us to go in there. I'll show you what Midas Touch does here. There we go. So we ended up touching both Grub and the Silkworm there. Unfortunately, we didn't kill Grub before it became unfrozen, but you saw that little bit amount of that little amount of money that we got from the Grub, from the Silkworm. We got a decent amount of money, nothing big. Rune Bag is going to give us random runes that drop every now and then. Very good if we need, like, say, a Degas rune, a Yara rune, Birth Row, etc. Eternal Heart is going to give us an HP upgrade next floor, as long as we don't lose it. Let's get some stats. How about that? Let's see some stat ups here. We did get a little bit of a damage up thanks to the steel bar, which would deal that concussive shot. That gray looking shot right there, and that's what the daze looks like. We do get some stats, and we don't get a double deal. Head on down to the next floor. Yeah, when I said stats, like, I was hoping maybe we could get, like, one that isn't movement speed. I mean, I'm glad we have movement speed and all, but if we could do something a little bit better, I'd appreciate it, game. HP, one of the few things that we actually don't need on this run. Get another blank deal with the devil. Thank you, Stan. All right, so no devil deals at all. You saw us get hit by that spider, and it was we have enough money to actually one-shot the spiders. If you get to 99 cents with Midas Touch, it actually deals a pretty significant amount of damage. I would say Sack Dagger levels of damage. Pretty good. Hoping that Rune Bag will help us out with Curse the Blind here. Had a little bit of a change of plans tonight on the stream, on the daily stream. We had I was planning on playing Shadows Die Twice, the new From Software game. I think I talked about it a little bit yesterday. And I bought it last night. It was installed. I was ready to go. But then, literally within 5 minutes of me going to my Twitch dashboard and getting ready for the stream to start, the bounty board popped up and showed that there were new bounties. I was like, oh, I might as well just check them, see what's going on. And they actually listed Shadows Die Twice. Sekiro Shadows Die Twice. And I was like, huh. And remember, this... Well, I don't know if I explained it in the Isaac video yesterday, but essentially it's a Japanese Dark Soul game. It's made by From Software. It's a Souls game. That's all you got to know. And I love Souls games. I love Dark Souls 3. It's the only Dark Souls I've actually played and made a legitimate attempt at beating, which I did do. And I became a fan of the entire genre, but I wasn't really, like, looking forward to this game, to Shadows Die Twice. So, like, it's one that kind of flew under the radar for me. I remember hearing it for E3, but I was just kind of like, eh, whatever. Like, you know, I don't get hype over games that aren't out yet, essentially. Really hoping that was going to be a Degas rune. Oh, yay. We hit Bumbo. Well, rejoice, everyone. Rejoice for those of you who've been waiting to see Bumbo. Bumbo is a follower that will steal all your money and essentially do nothing but troll you. He can deal damage. He can give you chests every now and then. I particularly don't care for Bumbo because I don't like having some random follower just pick up items that I don't, you know, or pick up my money and then give me items that I don't want, or troll bombs. Bumbo will troll you with the troll bombs. Anyway. Get a greed fight. And Bumbo's going to take all the money in here before I can. Bumbo will grow, by the way. The more money that Bumbo picks up, the larger he gets. The more damage he does. You get the Steam sales, so that's good. So I saw that bounty come out for Shadows Die Twice, and I was like, huh. Well, it's only been one day since I bought the game off of the Steam store, and I hadn't even opened it yet. I just simply installed it. So what I ended up doing was I refunded Shadows Die Twice on Steam because, I mean, let's face it, whenever there's a Twitch bounty for a game, for those of you who don't know how Twitch bounties work, essentially, whenever there's a bounty for a game that comes out that you don't own, Twitch will actually send you a copy of the game via usually like a Steam key or something like that. And I was like, you know, it's not a game that I'm dying to play. I'm certainly going to play it. I'm going to probably enjoy it a whole lot. But I can wait, you know. And the game that I paid for $60 of it, $60 on the Steam store. And I was like, you know what? I'm just going to go ahead and I'm just going to let them give me a refund back. Oh, we might as well use Pulse Worm. I'll get a refund. I'll get my $60 back, and then I'll get just a free copy of the game and then get paid for it. I was like, that makes sense to me. So I had to, in lieu of that, I had to find another game to play. And after Isaac, we went to One Finger Death Punch 2, which is a game that I didn't even know was out, which I was ironically way more excited to see than Shadows Die Twice. The game's been getting very good reviews, though. Shadows Die Twice, it is, although Mathis apparently hates it. But, I mean, what else is new? Oh, yeah. Head on down to the next floor here. I stuck with the black rune because it is possible we're going to see a bunch of items that we just don't want. And apparently we're just never going to get a devil deal item on this run. Oh, thank you, Bumbo. Thank you. That's another bad thing about Bumbo is that he's actually robbing us of Midas Touch damage as well, so... There's a lot of people really like Bumbo. I mean, hell, he's getting his own game. The Legend of Bumbo, but I personally don't care for the item at all. Bumbo is pretty good in Four Souls, though, I will say that. Yo. So we're going to get to the point now where our damage is really going to become an issue. And again, luckily we do have the HP to kind of counteract the lack of damage for now, but that's not going to be the case for too much longer. I would say that with 4.85 damage, that's only going to last us comfortably, Bumbo, until roughly depths, right after depths 2, I would say. Trying to use my key. And Wub, despite it looking like our tiers are much bigger, which they are, it's not actually giving us a damage upgrade. Thank you, Dump. I saw that, Bumbo. I saw you trying to win me over. I'm a cheap date, what can I say? If you toss me a black heart at the right time, and you know what? I'll be yours for the next 10 seconds. Tech 1 is not what I want. Can avoid it. Got a shot speed up, which is good, and a luck up. The black rune, the one that I just used on Tech 1. Sorry if I'm leaning away from my mic. My back is still actually like really hurting. I don't know what I did to it this past week, but it has not been fun being me for this week. But the black rune will essentially do what the void item does, the spacebar item. It will turn pedestal items into passive stats. Now, the key difference there is that the black rune will also take spacebar items and convert them into stats rather than absorbing what they do. So, for example, the void item, called void, the spacebar item itself, if you have a spacebar item on a pedestal and you use it, it's going to inherit whatever that spacebar item is. So, for example, if you use void on the shovel, the next time you use void, instead of it giving you stats, it's going to just do the shovel effect. Well, in that same scenario, if you have a black rune, you're not going to magically get the shovel effect. It's just going to turn it to raw stats. Since the black rune is considered a temporary consumable, it's not going to give you any lasting powers other than just the passive stat buffs that you get. So we get options. Might as well take it here because it's only depths 1. Rules card, Chub hates smoke. Rules no. Card. Go ahead and buy the battery as well. Not mean to buy that pill and Bumbo stole our nickel. Might as well try. I mean, the cork, sure, I suppose. We had the backpack, though. That would be very nice. The boss room should be right over here. Yeah. Saw the penny slots there for us to get inside of the door to the store and to the item room. That's from pay to play. Pay to win, pay to play. And the white question mark, also known as options or more options, will give us a double item pedestal after killing a boss instead of a single one, which is very good. Especially for a run like this, it gives us a much greater chance that we're actually going to get a stat that we want, like, say, damage. And we can pick and choose. And remember, the more options that you have in the game, the better. And that's not a pun intended, but it is true. That's the downside of having concussive tears right there is the fact that, much like Fear Shot, if they get dazed in any way while they're about to leap, they actually don't move anywhere. That's what ended up with costing us there. Come on, Bumbo, do something useful for a change instead of stealing all my money. I deal with the devil. Ears up and shot speed up. This is a pretty pivotal floor for us. We need to get damage. Now it's not a question of we want more damage. It's a question of we need to get more damage. Little Brimmy is going to help out a lot. But for the most part, his damage is going to really taper off here, especially if we don't have BFF, which we don't. If we get BFF, though, that would be a great upgrade for us because of the fact we do have, ironically, Bumbo, but also Little Brimstone. We get a Yara rune from the rune bag, which is great. Gives us potential game-breaking potential if we do run into blank card, which is still a very good chance with one more shop and an item room left. All right, it's just the follower train bonanza here today. I mean, we could go back and smelt the Arconium. Arconium is going to make black poop spawn greater abundance, which is great because they're good for crowd control, but they also deal AoE damage. It's fairly inconsequential to a run, but it is nice to find every now and then, especially combined with... Actually, Does petrified poop work on black poops? I don't know. Never even really thought about that. Damon's Tail again going ham here with the black hearts, and I appreciate that. Of course, I don't like losing him, but another Yara rune. Okay, so that Yara rune is important. If we can get a nickel here, we can... Well, essentially, if we get... We're going to roll until we find blank card. Oh, man. Humbling bundle. Even more options is pretty trash for us because there's no more item rooms coming up. Diplopia is worth taking? Question mark. Oh, man. Okay, we have to take Black Candle here. Our battery is going to give us double charges out of our space bar item. We're looking for Yara, though. Or we're looking for Blank Card, I mean. Blank Card, it's possible that we can find it still. No, it's not possible. Okay, we're going to Yara rune this. We're going to back out quickly. Grab the other Yara rune. Care of this again. Stop Bumbo from taking everything. Even I'm pretty sure Bumbo just took everything. That right there is the reason why I hate Bumbo. Okay, well, it didn't. I mean, hey, look, we got Black Candle. Black Candle is gonna make it to where we don't have to worry about curses anymore. Mom's key or Mom's purse is gonna give us double trinkets. We got car battery for essentially for free. And that's going to allow us to have double uses out of our space bar item. Of course, that's completely useless when we're talking about the trinket smelter, but if we do get a space bar item that's worth it, then, you know, it's going to be, well, worth it. Bumbo, I hate you. All right, so this is what happens when you have Midas touch and you let Mom stomp on you. Yeah. So, again, you get the first one for free. And then there's a cooldown timer that starts whenever you've already previously frozen Mom's foot. So right now would not be wise, although we did freeze it. So I guess this, I don't know how much time is in between freezing, but we're not going to take... this is just a follower train jamboree, I guess. I don't know what the internal cooldown is on Midas Touch's freezing ability, but apparently we're just not allowed to have, like, I mean, we've had zero damage ups. Even from the, no, we do not want Locus of War. Okay, now this could be interesting here. We have a Demon Judgment along with a regular Judgment. Let's play the Demon Judgment first. We can find a half heart, that'll be great, because that'll get us down to Polaroid Invincibility, allowing us to even have safer taps here. Get a Hermit card. Hermit card's going to allow us to teleport out of any room. Might as well teleport out of this room to a Hearts. Alright, fine, I'll use it. It's almost not even worth it for us to use the Hermit card. I might wait on it instead. Because, I mean, the Hermit card, if you use it in the chest or the cathedral, has a pretty decent shot at taking you closer to the boss. And really, the only reason why I'm even thinking about, like, I'm thinking about long term here for this run is because of the fact that we just don't have any damage. A majority of our damage is based on what little Brimstone and Bumbo are doing right now. And again, even though it looks like we have, like, Proptosis tiers, we obviously don't. Big Chub is also helping out a lot, so appreciate that, Big Chub. Yeah, let's go ahead. It's a little counterintuitive for us to spend money right now, especially with us having Midas Touch, but we don't have enough for it to really make that much of a difference in damage. And I think I've already established that our damage is not really all that great. So we don't have to worry about dealing damage with Isaac. We use other things to deal damage here. Really hoping that we find a half heart. Okay. Kind of weird how the... And now that I think about it, we have Humbling Bundle, so we can't find a half heart. I know the boss isn't over here. I'm just looking. Thank you, Bumbo. Got another Yara rune. That was, by the way, that was Bumbo leaving a troll bomb for us. It's a strange run because it's in one aspect of this run you've got a bad run, right? Like, you look at our stats and you think, like, well, yeah, they've got good tiers, right, good movement speed, but that damage is just pathetic. But we're clearing at a decent speed, and that's because of the fact that we have a good amount of shot speed now, and B, little Brimstone's doing the bulk of the heavy lifting for us. The same trick on Mom's foot works for Triacnid as well as Daddy Longlegs as well. Of course, I'm just lying out my you-know-what, because apparently that's completely not true. Finally get a damage up here, and we get another follower in Eye of Belial. Now, the Eye of Belial is going to be a big pickup for us. So we're going to take Brother Bobby. We'll take Eye of Belial. We'll just ignore the Demon Judgment, and... Now, Eye of Belial, it doesn't give us a direct stat upgrade, but what it does do, it gives us a little bit more damage output, because whenever the tier travels through something, it deals double damage or something like that. Now, obviously, Synthoil did give us a raw damage up, which is very good. You know, obviously, the more damage you have, the better, yada yada. I mean, I think that anyone who's ever heard of one of my videos, I probably said something about how important damage is. So, okay, all right, let's just stop getting ping-ponged in this room. We're getting to the point now where we have so many followers, it's difficult to see the incoming projectiles. And that's one reason why I also don't like taking this many followers. You have to account for the fact that we also have mystery... We also have, I'm gonna Euro rune this. We also have mystery sack, and we also have the rune bag. I'm gonna Euro rune this. Stay on the safe side. If we can get down to polar invincibility, that'd be great. This is essentially the last chance we have to do it on. For devil deals, anyway. Now, the downside to Eye of Belial has already been pretty apparent, as you've seen, almost saw again here, is that we don't have any knockback with our shots anymore. That's due to the fact that Eye of Belial is piercing. So, you have to be a little bit careful about that. That's the reason why we were getting ping-ponged around in that Diglett room, was because I could not get the white Diglets to get away from us. And then, of course, trying to dodge away from them caused us to take damage because we were dodging into the shots from the red Diglets. No deal with the devil, no surprise, and we'll just... keep on going. So now we're really hoping that we get a teleportation card, preferably an Emperor card. It would be nice if we get another Yara rune so we can get an extra couple items here in the chest. Another Soul Heart. I appreciate that, game. Thank you very much. Game has been very generous. Get out of jail free card. That would allow us to fight Mega Satan, but... I don't necessarily think this is a Mega Satan killing build. I mean, could we? Probably, but it would take a long time. 6.37 damage is not conducive with what I would say is a good amount of damage. Got another Degas rune, is gonna give us another Soul Heart and clear the curse. Of course, we don't have any curses because we have Black Candle. Going a little bit heavier on the strategy side today. I don't really have too much to talk about. I mean, other than, you know, One Finger Death Punch 2 and Shadows Die Twice. I always feel weird saying Japanese names because, like, I want to put, like, a Japanese flair on it, you know, like some accents. But A, it could come off as incredibly racist, and B, you know, I don't know. That's why I'm not good at acting, because I can't do accents. Like, anytime I try to speak Spanish, for example, and I'm not just saying like llave, I'm saying like legitimately speak Spanish when I go to, like, you know, restaurants and whatever, you know, I always feel weird. I always feel like that lame dude who, it's clearly like, you know those people I'm talking about, the people who clearly don't speak the language that they're trying to emulate, and then they try, like, they like overcompensate for the They, like, overcompensate the accent to make it sound more authentic. You know what I'm talking about? Like some woman in Subway would be like, you know, yeah, I'd like a turkey sandwich, and can you give extra jalapenos? You know, it sounds lame, you know? Like, it sounds like a comedian bit. So I try not to say, like, the names of non-English things, proper nouns. Because it always comes out, I always end up sounding weird and just sounds lame. Probably should have taken that Soul Heart into Gaz rune, but what can you do? All right, we're on the chest. I mean, are we going to be okay in this run? Probably. Now, we do have Eye of Belial, which is, again, piercing shots and a good amount of shot speed and tears rate. So, theoretically, the shielded tears here is going to be a very big get for us as far as defense goes. Contact Lens will essentially cancel out any projectiles that is shot our way with our shots. So our shots cancel out other projectiles. A little bit sad that we don't have another trinket. We could have smelt it. It's been a little bit since we've had that. But keep your eye on the fires here from Megamon. You'll see exactly what I'm talking about right there. Completely canceled out all of those shots just simply shooting our tears through Megamon. Of course, it doesn't work on day long legs, but... get my point. So it's very powerful against bosses that do have like a bullet hell attack pattern. You know, it's very good against Hush, especially with Eye of Belial, because Hush is so big. It's essentially impossible for you to take as much damage. You can't take more damage. He says as he takes more damage. You can't take more damage with the contact lens than you could without it. Yeah, that's what I meant to say. Like, you'll always have some form of mitigation from incoming projectiles as long as you have a decent tears rate. Now, that being said, as good as the contact lens may seem, it's not an automatic pickup, at least not for me. Because if you don't have any sort of piercing shots, and especially if you don't have a good tears rate, it can actually harm you badly. Because at that point, you're going up against mobs who have a better tier rate than you, who can outgun you, and then you just get in trouble because all your shots, you're not doing any damage. Like, you're not making any connected shots because they're all being wasted on colliding with the enemy's incoming projectiles that are traveling already much faster, at a much faster rate and a much faster pace than you are. They're outpacing your damage. So be careful whenever you take, if you see the contact lens, don't think it's automatic pickup. I do not recommend taking the contact lens unless you have at least 8 on your tiers, on your tier delay. If you have anything over 8, I wouldn't recommend it. Some people will probably say, don't listen to Simvicta, he's being too wishy-washy here. But hey, you know, I'm just letting you know. That's sort of the baseline. And normally I don't even pick up Shield of Tears because I just don't like my tears colliding with others. Like, I like predictability. I like knowing that if I shoot a tear, it's going to come out of Isaac's head in some way, collide with the target that's in front of me, and it's going to either kill them or it's going to make them, you know, get knocked back a little bit. By piercing shots, I expect my shots to actually just deal damage totally to the target. So the contact lens doesn't really give you that sort of predictability, but in this case, you can see how powerful it is. I'm not going to take Pop because Pop is just worthless against Blue Baby. It would also really hurt the fact that we have Shielded Tears, but overall, very good run. I don't know what to say with it. It's a weird run because we didn't have any Devil Deals up until the last one. We got Iron Belial, so it was definitely a follower-heavy type run. The Bumbo Train. Bumbo just having fun, just chilling out. You're seeing here how we're basically just pointing and laughing at Blue Baby, how we can't do anything, because all of our tears are just... The piercing effect plus the Eye of Belial plus Shielded Tears is just hilariously overpowered. Thank you for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Remember, let's get those videos up over at least 1,000 likes. I really do truly appreciate it. I hope you had a great start to your weekend. I hope you enjoyed the first look at One Finger Death Punch 2. Hollow Knight will be coming out a little bit later on today. Until next time, so long, everybody.